Hello, and welcome to Southwest Side Report's WP Coffee Break, WordPress answers and the time it takes to have a cup of coffee. Today we're going to dive into a single plugin, Ultimate FAQ. Do you find yourself answering the same questions over and over about your company, organization, or product? Then you need a FAQ. A FAQ, or FAQ, is a list of frequently asked questions. It's a great way for your site visitors to get quick answers, as well as a time saver for you or your support staff. A FAQ on your site could be as simple as making a page called FAQ and writing out questions and answers. But a FAQ plugin can help streamline the process and make it easier to manage. It can also enable fancy FAQ-specific styling, group questions by category, and even export the FAQ as a PDF manual. Let's get started by installing the Ultimate FAQ plugin. Go to the plugin repository, search for Ultimate FAQ, install it, and activate it. The first thing it asks us is to give it a category name for our first FAQ. I'm going to call this category House Cleaning, enter a description, and click Add Category. You can add more categories, so I'll add a second one. You might need more, or maybe none, depending on how broad or narrow the topics are for your FAQ. After adding categories, we click Next. Now we can add questions and answers for our FAQ. I'll quickly add some house cleaning tips. Notice that the edit box provided for the answer is quite small. If you have a lot of questions to answer or long answers, you should wait and do it later when you have the full WordPress editor available. After each answer, select the category, then click Add. After we've added a few questions, click Next. Don't worry if you can't think of them all right now. You'll be able to add, change, and delete the questions later. Now we have the option to create a page to put the FAQ on. I'm going to do this and call the page House Cleaning FAQ. Click Create to make the page, and then we get some options to change. I'm going to leave these all at their defaults for now, and we'll look at them more a little later. Click Finish to complete the setup. After the setup, Ultimate FAQ has a little slideshow to introduce you to different features. I like self-documenting plugins that put some effort into helping you understand them. Definitely go through those to get the lay of the land. The first thing to do after you activate a new plugin is find out how to access the plugin's settings and controls. For this one, Ultimate FAQ has added a menu item in the dashboard sidebar, simply called FAQs. We click that and we get the options page for Ultimate FAQ. I click FAQs and we get an interface that looks a lot like the standard WordPress posts or pages lists. Click Edit and we can edit this question and its answer. Let's go back to FAQs. As I'm looking at this list, I see that I neglected to set the category for the sponge question. I'll do quick edit and see that you can edit a lot of the properties of this question, including the category. I'll do that, click update, and now back in the FAQ list, I can see that they all have categories now. I recall that in the setup, it created a FAQ page for me. Let's find that and see what it looks like. This may be a little surprising. All this page has on it is this text inside brackets. When you see text in square brackets in WordPress, that's a short code. Short codes are used to pull content from plugins into your posts, pages, and widget areas. It's like a little placeholder that you insert. When this page is viewed on the website, you won't see the short code. Instead, you'll see whatever the plugin produces inserted wherever you placed it. When we view this page on the site, we see the shortcode is replaced with the questions and answers from our FAQ. This is the default styling for Ultimate FAQ. You can click any question, and it expands to show you the answer. If you click another, it opens that one up too, and you can scroll around the page to read them. One last thing I want to do before we look at the FAQ options is to put this page on a menu so my visitors can see it. I'll go to the Dashboard, Appearance, Menus, and then add the house cleaning page to the menu. Now I'll check the site and see that it got added just where we want it. Now let's look at some options for our FAQ. We'll go through a few of these, and you can explore the ones we don't cover on your own. The little eye icon next to each option pops up a description of what that option does, so it's pretty easy to figure these out. The first thing we'll look at is Set Access Role. By default, only the admin can edit the FAQs. If you have more than one person working on your website, you might want to give someone the ability to edit the FAQ, but not admin access to the whole site. A common setting for this would be editor or author, which would correspond to people who are allowed to modify content on your site. The setting here is the least permission required, so if you set it to author, that means authors, editors, and admins can all edit the FAQs. Next, let's look at this CSS option. CSS is what controls the styling of things on the web. It controls colors, fonts, backgrounds, etc. It's a really deep subject, and we don't have time to get into it here, so I've got this little bit of magic CSS that I'm going to enter into this box. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see a video on how we came up with this particular CSS text. Basically, what I'm adding here is a border around the question and answer, and filling in the background color of each, just to give it a little visual interest. And now our FAQ looks a little more interesting. Of course, you would want to pick colors that match the theme of your site. Next, let's look at the FAQ accordion option. Currently, when you click a FAQ question, it displays the answer, and then if you click another, it opens that one up too. That works okay on big screens, but the accordion option is a bit more space efficient. We'll turn that on, then go back to our FAQ. Now each time we open one question, it closes the previous one. I think most people prefer this, but there are some cases where it might be important to see more than one answer at the same time. You can decide what's best for your site. You may have noticed that we called our FAQ page house cleaning, but we have a car repair question in there. We put it in a different category, but it's still displayed with the cleaning questions. To limit that display to only that category, we start by going to the Categories tab in the FAQ options. Make note of the slug for the house cleaning category. The slug is automatically assigned by the plugin when you create a category. Now we go to the page which has our FAQ shortcode. Many shortcodes support options to tell them how to behave. In this case, the Ultimate FAQs shortcode has an Include Category option where we can tell it to only display the questions from a specific category. We'll set that to house cleaning here, save it, and look at the FAQ. Now we only have three questions because the car question is gone. We could have a different FAQ page which only displays the car category. Also, you can use exclude category instead of include category, and it will include all of the categories except the ones you mention. Now that this FAQ only has a single category of questions, it seems redundant to display the category name in each answer. So let's go to the settings. Turn on the Hide Categories option, and check it out. It's just a little more tidy this way. I hope this intro to the Ultimate FAQ plugin has been useful. We haven't covered everything in the free version, and they also have a premium option that adds even more. Two of the most interesting features I see in the premium option are the ability to export your FAQ to a PDF file, and the extra styling options. As you saw, we can style it with custom CSS, but it's easier to do if you just have a menu to select colors and fonts from. Another thing we didn't cover here is the import option. If you already have questions and answers collected in some other format, you may be able to import them, which can save a lot of work over cutting and pasting them all. This has been a WP Coffee Break from Southwest Cyberport, a cutting-edge WordPress hosting provider in the heart of the American Southwest. If you need fast, secure, and friendly WordPress hosting, head over to swcp.com/coffee to check us out. If you have any questions or suggestions for future video topics, leave a message in the comments. Thanks for watching, and please don't forget to like and subscribe.